I heard you say you're gonna have three parades if you want one of those suspensions. Is that true?
Well, you know, the thing is, there's so many people who've helped my family and I out since I've been in Hamilton, because right now we split time as far as my family, because when the boys get back to school and with everything we have going back in Calgary, once Labor Day comes around, the family usually went from Hamilton back to Calgary. So, you know, if we're able to get this done, you know, I want to make sure I say thank you to those people. And one of the best ways is to get the Grey Cup out there and allow them and their kids and our families, our Canadian family out in Calgary, to experience something that normally, you know, the kids wouldn't have an opportunity to. And you know, that would be something that, you know, for us, you know, I mean, what they've done for us has already been heartfelt, and to be able to give them something in return would be something that, you know, especially the families and the kids would never forget, and it's more of a way for us to say thank you. And it's not so much a parade, but it's a way just to get people together who've really been there for us during this time and truly say thank you in that fashion.
Considering where you're at in your career, not considering the fact that it's in Regina, just overall, how much does this week mean to you?
It means a lot. I mean, at the end of the day, you know, to be able to win multiple Grey Cups, especially as a quarterback, really helps ensure your legacy as far as you know, what type of you know, feeling you'll have coming away from the game. I mean, to be able to play this game for 16 seasons and right now just have two, but really one as a starter, to be able to win multiple with multiple organizations, I mean, that would be amazing. That would be an amazing feeling. And more importantly, to be able to give a ring to each and every one of the members of my family who I've had to travel around Canada playing in different markets. You know, my wife, Nicole, and my boys, Armand and Baron, you know, I want to make sure that if there's something that they can take away from this, is for each of them to have a ring that they can have for their own forever. And so this is what this is all about. I mean, of course, for me to be able to reward my family and give them something, and as far as an experience that you normally can't get, to me that's more important than my legacy, because as long as they're happy dealing with all the stuff that they had to put up with, you know, throughout this journey, to me that trumps everything.
How has your family helped you throughout these years then?
You know, just being supportive. And, you know, of course, whenever, you know, one thing about having children and having your wife at home is, regardless if you played a great game or a bad game or people booed you out of the stadium or whatever it was, whenever you came home, you always got the same reaction. You know, my two boys running up to me and jumping on me, screaming daddy and stuff. You know, that overrides everything. I mean, just to hear them saying that, regardless of what the situation is, sorry, I'm always smiling at the end of the day. And, you know, just to be able to say thank you for that and to have that support staff there along with everybody else that we have, it makes it worthwhile.
It's interesting you mentioned your first Grey Cup when you weren't a starter, because Darian wasn't a starter. And he talks about that, which doesn't have as much meaning to him as the next Grey Cup ring. You kind of,
yeah.
What did it mean to get that one in 08 as a starting quarterback?
Well, back in, what was it, 98? Ooh. Yeah. I know I'm kind of old, right? But back in 98, you know, playing behind the likes of Jeff Garcia and Dave Dickinson, it showed me a lot about what it took to prepare yourself and the little things that you had to do to be successful as a quarterback in this league and to be able to guide your team to win Grey Cup championships. And just to be able to take that foundation that they set for me and to see the type of work that they put in allowed me to prepare myself to do what it took to help my team become successful. And now to be here at the end of the day, I mean, it comes full circle. And I always tell those guys thank you. I tell Dave thank you. I'll send him a text here and there, and same with Jeff Garcia. But, of course, yeah, I mean, when you're out there playing, you know, you're shedding more blood, sweat, and tears, and you're putting your life on the line for your team. And it definitely means much more to you at the end of the day, because you had a more primary, you know, as far as effect, as far as on your team winning a championship, whereas as a backup, you're more of a secondary effect, you know, more of a moral guy. But to be out there, I mean, this is what you play for, to be able to have a sole purpose to go out there and win championships. And that's why we play the game that we do. I mean, we're competitors. We're modern-day warriors. And, I mean, to be out there and win the ultimate crown is what you live for, what you battle for, and what you sacrifice for.
Are you surprised Dave's been such a successful coach already?
Oh, no. Dave, I mean, he's a brainiac. I mean, I never thought he was a player when I first saw him. I mean, you know, the guy is he's probably 5'4", you know, Dave is one of the fiercest competitors I've ever played against, and he goes about it the same way when he coaches and when he prepares. I mean, he prepares as if he's playing another game, and he puts each and every one of his quarterbacks in positions to be successful, and that's why, regardless if he's had, you know, guys coming in off of Air Canada flights the day of the game, they've had success in the game because Dave prepares his guys properly. So it definitely doesn't surprise me.